How I built a floating bed frame for less than $100. We started by cutting up some wood. We had 9 1x3s, 5 2x4s, 2 more 2x4s, and I'll show you how I made these 2x4s later in this video. But we are rolling into step 2, which is assembly. Measuring from the inside of the last 2x4, we put marks at every 18¾ inch. But I'm not the sharpest crayon in the tool shed, so I made a mark at half to make it line up. And then I nailed it together. We are balling on a budget, and nails are cheaper than screws. With the basic frame together, it was time for the feet. To make these, it took me 1 2x4 at 12 inches, sandwiched between 2 at 15½. I put them 13 inches away from the side, and I added 2 more at the end of the headboard for extra support. And then it was time for the platform. I put marks down every 6 inches. There are 3 inches between each board, and it is the perfect size. To secure the board, I use a brad nail gun, but you could use any finished nail or screw. And now it's finally time to install the lights and make this thing float. I used clear tape to secure the lights on the top facing outward. I made sure to wrap it around all the legs. Once it was set, I made sure to pull the remote transmitter out from underneath the bed. It's looking decent, but we're not done yet. We went back to Home Depot, and our girl Paige hooked us up with a couple pieces of common board to cover up these ugly edges. That looks so much better. And for just $69, that is...